because they don't need the hassle of worrying about the parking. And there's a pricing disadvantage with operating a business in the city of Kingston too. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
Next speaker.
Jeremy Labor.
Jeremy Labor, 41 Mercer Street, Kingston. I'm not going to ask you to recite the Bill of Rights, but I'm asking the council to continue with tabling the resolution on bonding for the kiosks. And I didn't prepare anything, but I wrote some facts down. You know, I used to serve as a parking officer in the city of Kingston. And, you know, those are the people, first I'm going to say, I think the mayor's work group is is a good thing. You know, I think it's been a long time, if it's backed up correctly. It's been a long time before anyone has looked at parking in a proactive way rather than a reactive way. You know, 13 years ago, in 2003 or so, the Common Council voted to take the meters out. Chris Gagne was all in World War II at the time, decided then, you know, listening to uptown business owners, that this was not the correct way to go. So the council took the meters out, and within 3 years later, in 2007, Alton Bill Reynolds, the majority leader, with Mike Madsen, got the meters reinstalled within a three-year period. Now you can imagine the cost associated, you know, with ripping up meters, putting a two-hour free parking system in, and then 3 years later, you know, going back to the way we did business before. You know, so, you know, again, you know, my thought would be, you know, two things. One, in terms of revenue, you can figure out the gaps just by talking with the parking staff. I mean, you know, the way the parking office is run, where you deal with John Tilley, the controller, as the boss, and you don't have a clear supervisor, that's an issue. John Tilley is a very competent controller, and he was a very good boss. However, he doesn't have the time to deal with the parking, you know, as it needs to be official. You know, before the budget committee, when you guys do a budget, you should hear from the people that are on the streets every day writing those tickets, dealing with the uptown business people, dealing with the town business people, you know, generating, they're one of the few departments that generate profit. Those are the people, regardless of how this plays out, whether you get kiosks or Kingston, you know, what thing that was called. I'm not in favor of privatization of parking, but all those things should be talked about at the parking committee. And to bond, you know, before that, to bond for kiosks before this parking committee has made any decisions, I think is a mistake. There's a reason why, you know, this requests third majority to get passed, and that's because our bond rating is at risk. So we may be buying, you know, we may be making the same mistake we made 13 years ago when, you know, we should be making progress. And the progress would be for this council to hold the mayor to his promise by doing nothing. That way you guys, you know, properly represent the checks and balances. You know, let's, you know, make, you know, this be the first administration and council that does the right thing and looks at a long-term solution to parking. Because there is one there. The parking department is 10 years behind, you know, equivalent cities. But the staff and the staff that is there, you know, could make the city parking one of the best in the state. So it's really, you know, just a matter of the parking committee looking at all aspects of parking and making a decision. It's not about kiosks, you know. Parking is not about parking. Parking is about people. And one thing both the mayor and the common is you guys are in the business of helping people. So I would ask you guys to do nothing until the parking committee has, you know, given their recommendations to you and to the mayor's office. Thank you.
Next speaker.
Guy Kemp.
Well, good evening. I'm wondering if Paige could assist me for a second.
Could you distribute that?
Can you distribute that? One for each of you. Thank you. Thanks so much. I have one for you too. So, good evening. My name is Guy Kemp. I'm Vice President of Community Development at RUPCO, and I'm actually a resident of the town and village of New Paltz, but I work here in Kingston. I'm glad to come here every day. I'm here to speak with you about something that doesn't involve parking. I hope that's refreshing. I want to speak to you about the almshouse, the the Kingston Arms House at 300 Flatbush Avenue was built in 1872, as many of you know, and is the very first building erected by the city of Kingston. It was established to care for the city's poor. Ulster County acquired the property from the city in 1954 and continued the tradition of caring for the community by using the building as a chronic care infirmary. Ulster County later used the building, of course, as their Department of Health. On August 5th, 2015, Ulster County Legislator Dave Donaldson of Kingston introduced a resolution in the county legislature to nominate the structure to the state and federal registers of historic places. However, on August 12th, the Ulster County Legislature Economic Development, Tourism, Housing, Planning, and Transit Committee, must have a very busy agenda, voted down Resolution 295 to support the consideration of the almshouse to the state and national registers of historic places. It seems to me that the county legislature was somewhat indifferent to their stewardship of the historic building. Nevertheless, on August 26th of 2015, County Executive Mike Kind announced alongside Friends of Historic Kingston that the property would be nominated to the registers. He said, quote, "We are excited to ensure this majestic building remains intact for generations to come." And it certainly is a pleasure today to look back and see that Dave Donaldson and the county executive were in complete agreement about the importance of preserving that structure. Then on September 1st of 2015, this Common Council unanimously endorsed Resolution 187 by the City of Kingston to support the nomination of the almshouse to the state and federal registers. So I'm here tonight and I've delivered to you, members of the Common Council, copies of the Part 1 Evaluation of Significance, which was prepared and submitted to the National Park Service by RUPCO on January 5th of this year. In conclusion, the nomination states, quote, The Kingston City Almshouse Complex is significant under Criterion A for its association with social history in the lives of Kingston and Ulster County. It is significant for its function as an almshouse between 1874 and 1948, and later as a county infirmary and hospital from 1954 to 1973. The Kingston Almshouse Complex is representative of the City of Kingston's evolved care of the poor from the 19th to the mid-20th century. Just wanted to share with you that the nomination is under consideration by the National Park Service. It has already been deemed eligible by the State Historic Preservation Board, the state office. And the process from here goes forward. We will submit once we have approvals, local approvals, of and all of our plans for the property are permitted. That will be submitted to the National Park Service in a Part 2, the description of rehabilitation of the property. And once the project is complete, there will be what is called a Part 3, which is a request for certification of the completed work, which will be done in accordance with the standards of the United States Secretary of the Interior. And it's also subject to the approval of the National Park Service. And it was my pleasure to bring that to you tonight. I feel that we've acted on a resolution of the Common Council, and God, I don't get a chance to do that every day. Thank you very much.
That concludes the public speaking portion.
I'm sorry, I didn't have a chance to sign up, but I'll be very brief. My name is Alona Ross, 48 Third Avenue, and I was very intrigued by what the third speaker spoke about when he discussed the Fourth Amendment, the violations of the Fourth Amendment. And so I Googled it until my phone died, and what I actually found out is very interesting, that these kiosk companies, I'm sure you all know that the Fourth Amendment prohibits the federal government, at the very minimum, the federal government from collecting information in a wholesale fashion, but it turns out that private companies are not forbidden to do the same, as I'm sure you know. And curiously, the Department of Homeland Security has funded quite a bit of these kiosk companies, according to an article that I just read, I was wondering whether the council had ascertained whether this particular kiosk company has in fact received any money from the Department of Homeland Security. And one can assume, one can conclude that probably this information will be used, will be funneled to federal bodies in violation as a ground outlet of getting around in the Fourth Amendment. And I was wondering if there's any inconsistency also, since presumably this council voted to become a sanctuary city precisely to avoid giving information to the federal government, which is what, of course, Department of Immigration is supposed to be doing themselves, if INS would be doing, if there's any inconsistency in having you, the council, vote for a kiosk company that almost certainly would do the exact same thing, provide information to a federal body. So I'm just wondering if there's an inconsistency there. And secondly, lastly, I have to wonder, what is the financial inducement to accept a kiosk company over other methods of providing the same revenue?
Okay, that concludes our public speaking portion of the council meeting. Everybody stand closed. Now move on to claims and communications. Hearing no discussion, shall be on file in the clerk's office. I get a motion to dispense with the reading, the second reading of the general bills and pay sanctions.
Motion. Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed. The bills are paid 9-0. We now enter into board of committees. Go to resolution number 24.
Resolution number 24, 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, recommending approval for modifications to the 2016 Department of Public Works budget.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 25.
Resolution number 25 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, recommending approval for modifications to the 2016 Fire Department budget.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor? Opposed. Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now go to resolution number 26.
Resolution number 26 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, recommending approval for modifications to the 2016 wastewater treatment facility budget.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed. Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 27.
Resolution number 27 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, recommending approval for modifications to the 2016 wastewater treatment facility budget.
On the question. Hearing no debate, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now go to resolution number 28.
Resolution number 28 of 2017, an ordinance amending an ordinance in relation to traffic on public streets in the City of Kingston, New York, and handicap parking on Linwood Place.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. Now move on to resolution number 29.
Resolution number 29 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, establishing the Live Well Kingston Commission.
On question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 31.
Resolution number 30 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, requesting that the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation, as co-lead agency, requires submission and implementation of an enhanced public participation plan under CP 29 for the City of Kingston and all other potential environmental justice area communities identified as potentially affected by the Pilgrim Pipeline project prior to the commencement of scoping under SECR.
On question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move to resolution number 31.
Resolution number 31 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to enter into an agreement with the Ulster County SPCA.
On the question, Alderman Carey.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. Since there seemed to be a lot of issues that came up last night, and it doesn't seem to be a real urgency on this, I would request that we send this back to committee for review so we can get some of the questions something we're so sure of. So I think we make a motion to refer this back to committee.
Do I have a second?
Second.
To refer back?
Second.
Yes, I think I already second.
Okay, we have a first and a second to refer back. On the question, to refer back. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor to refer back?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is referred back, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 32.
Mr. President, I have a question.
Alderman Nelson.
With these 32 and forward with the grant applications, can these be read in a group or do they need to be read separately?
With these resolutions for
grant applications.
I would, to be on the safe side, think it's better to do them individually in case they need a document sent to each one, you know what I mean?
Okay.
I appreciate your effort. Okay, resolution number 32.
Resolution 32 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application to the New York State Department of Transportation for a Transportation Alternatives Program grant in the amount of $580,464 for the Kingston Point Rail Trail Streetscape Connection Project and to execute any and all related documents.
On the question, hearing no debate, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move to resolution number 33.
Resolution number 33 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application to the New York State Department of Transportation for a Transportation Alternatives Program grant in the amount of $1,348,524 for the Midtown Safe Routes to School project and to execute any and all related documents.
On question, hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 34.
Resolution number 34 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit a grant application to People for Bikes in order to become a Big Jump community to receive technical assistance valued at $750,000 and to execute any and all related documents.
On the question, hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. Now move on to resolution number 35.
Resolution number 35 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application to the Department of Homeland Security for an assistance to firefighters grant program in the amount of $409,091 for vehicle acquisitions and to execute any and all related documents.
On the question, hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now go to resolution number 36.
Resolution number 36 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application application to the Ulster County Transportation Council for a pavement rehabilitation and complete streets TIP project in the amount of $359,000 for the Broadway Streetscape project to execute any and all related documents.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We have a resolution number 37.
Resolution number 37 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application to the Ulster County Transportation Council for a pavement rehabilitation and complete streets TIP project in the amount of $451,639 for the Early Avenue Paving and Complete Streets project to execute any and all related documents.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now go to resolution number 38.
Resolution number 38 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application to the Ulster County Transportation Council for a pavement rehabilitation and complete streets TIP project in the amount of $146,772 for the Prince Street Paving and Kingston Green Line Connection project to execute any and all related documents.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. Now move on to resolution number 39.
Resolution number 39 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application to the Ulster County Transportation Council for a pavement rehabilitation and complete streets TIP project in the amount of $372,485 for the Wilbur Avenue paving project to execute any and all related documents.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 40.
Resolution number 40 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to submit an application to the New York State DEC for a Hudson River Estuary Program grant in the amount of $24,500 for an open space plan for the City of Kingston and to execute any and all related documents.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 41.
Resolution number 41 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing the mayor to expend funds in the first instance for the 2016 Greenway Conservancy Trail Grant from the Hudson River Valley Greenway for the Hasbrook at Delaware Road on the Kingston Point Rail Trail.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. We now move on to resolution number 42.
Resolution number 42 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, to accept the recommendations of the Ulster County Planning Board, City of Kingston Planning Board, and Historic Landmark Preservation Commission with regard to the petition to rezone 300 Flatbush Avenue.
On the question.
Mr. President.
Alderman Davis.
I'd like to make a motion to amend the resolution 42 to read the resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, to receive the recommendations of the Ulster County Planning Board, the City of Kingston Planning Board, and the Historic Landmark Preservation Commission with regard to the petition to rezone 300 Flatbush Avenue.
Is
Resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York to, City of Kingston, New York acknowledging receipt of the recommendations of the Ulster County Planning Board, City of Kingston Planning Board, and Historic Landmark Preservation Commission with regard to petition to rezone 3 and 5 Avenue.
Okay, everybody good with that?
Well, that's not what Tony had suggested. I know last night we said that we were going to change the word accept to receive, so I'm not sure why we're not.
Well, it just doesn't make good grammar, I think. That's the only reason.
Don't make good grammar?
Same thing, right?
Just acknowledging receipt of saying you have received it.
I said that. Acknowledging receipt of.
Once accepted, I have. Not accepted, but recommendations.
Acknowledge receipt of.
Okay, so what are we putting next? What do you want?
Can you read back in the card, I'm sorry?
Yep.
Just read that one.
Instead of to accept, it would say acknowledging receipt of the recommendations of the Ulster County Planning Board. And blah, blah, blah. Okay, I give it that.
Or you just acknowledge the recommendation.
What?
How about just to acknowledge the recommendation?
Receipt is the.
Receipt, same thing, I mean, let's not get picky here, it's very easy.
Acknowledge the thing.
Okay, so I have a motion and a second on the question. Do I call for the vote?
Please.
Please. All favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Amendment? Acknowledged, signed 0, we are now going to vote on the resolution as amended. On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote, all favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. And now move on to resolution number 43.
Resolution number 43 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, to hold determination on the petition to rezone 300 Flatbush Avenue in advance pending completion of the secret review process.
On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is adopted, 9-0. Now move on to resolution number 44.
Resolution number 44 of 2017, ordinance to the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, amending section 405-55F zoning procedures.
On the question.
What the heck did we pull?
I thought we were requiring.
Hello.
Mr. President, I'd like to.
Honestly, go ahead.
I'd like to move to amend, I mean to table or send back to committee resolution number 44, amending our zoning procedures. We need a public hearing.
So you're referring it back?
I am referring it back.
For the purpose of public hearing?
Exactly.
To be held at 6:15 on.
6:15 at the next. Bond screen, which is the third Thursday of the month.
Well, you all.
6:15.
Okay, do I have a second?
Second.
Okay, on the motion. On the question. Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote to refer back. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution is referred back, 9-0. Now move on to resolution number 45.
Resolution number 45 of 2017, resolution of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, authorizing adopting a bond ordinance in the sum of $125,000 to fund the purchase of pay stations for off-street parking.
Mr. President.
On the question, Alderman Nelson.
Point of order.
that I believe this is out of order. It is substantially the same resolution that was defeated at last month's meeting, regardless of the attempt to change a few words. But it does not affect the meeting as the same as last month. It's to circumvent the council rules. And I'd like to refer to the council rules that we all are in receipt of. Rule number 6, reconsideration of motions or resolutions. No motion for the reconsideration of any vote shall be in order unless at the same time or the next regular meeting of the Common Council to that on which the decision proposed to reconsider took place, and unless a member who voted the majority thereon shall move such reconsideration. But a motion to reconsider made for the purpose of correction of error in any ordinance or resolution shall be considered a privileged motion to any member and shall always be in order. Per the Common Council rules, we as a council unanimously passed them in January of 2017, which I just read. As you know, the resolution requires 6 votes to pass. It only received 5 votes previously, thus it was defeated. Therefore, the prevailing side in this case are the 3 no votes. The word majority in the rules in this case is the prevailing side, which are the no votes. I am of opinion a motion to reconsider the bond resolution that was defeated can only come from 1 of the 3 no votes. This did not occur, and we as a council took an oath to represent the city and openly and honestly and to abide by the rules as set forth in the Common Council rules. This is unethical against the Common Council rules. It's being submitted because Alderman Koo is present this evening and was absent at the last meeting, which could affect what the vote would be tonight. I believe that our open communication and open government request to re-vote and go against an open and honest vote that took place in January. So I'm making a motion that we cannot have a re-vote on this based on the Common Council rules, which we are in receipt of, and I would like to ask that a re-vote not take place. I'd also like to continue with the parking issue. Parking issues are not new in Kingston. Decades ago, when I was a small child and walked uptown, and we used to have Schefter's Market, the same parking lot there was metered. The street across the street was metered. And decades ago, it was asked, why were these metered when our Kingston Plaza didn't charge for parking and our big box stores didn't charge for parking, or the mall, even though they were out of the city of Kingston, it was where people could shop and not have to pay. What is new is the kiosks for the parking lot, which has generated much conversation and how they can be best suited for the city of Kingston as we move forward. I am not against them, but the process has not been vetted properly. There is much being said in regard to the situation from the Uptown Business Associations, owners, renters, Kingston Citizens Group, and members of the council. Just last night, Alderman Dawson raised concerns of affordability for the hospital employees. Alderman Carey stated that visitors from surrounding areas, such as Port Hume, Woodstock, and Sorbies, are the visitors that will contribute to the revenue. Alderman Scott Childress believes we should move forward with the funding and favors the formation of a committee to address issues and goals on a forward basis rather than look at the options that have been offered from the public, the mayor, and the council as a whole prior to bonding. It seems to me that the committee should address the issue from point A instead of starting somewhere in the middle. We are hearing the concerns now, and we should address the issue at hand now prior to approving anything. Let's remember, the 2017 budget was passed with what-ifs. The what-ifs, that it was imperative to get the parking up and running as soon as possible because the budget was built on this potential revenue. The impact of this potential revenue has the opportunity to have an impact on the entire city, and there is concern now that taxes will increase if the bond was not passed. Where were these concerns during the making of and the reviewing of this budget? This and many other reasons is why I was a no vote on the 2017 budget. This was not a well-thought plan. The RFP process, the revenue, the budget, and the committee established after the fact. I believe each of us on the council has a commitment to our constituents
and the taxpayers of the city and the impact this will have. I ask that you vote no. It will not be forgotten. And for the record, I was advised that the kiosks were not ordered and they are not in our position, and I just think that should be noted on the record. But I would like to go back to that, the council rules, and that we cannot, Alderman Brown, myself, or Alderman Dawson did not reconsider this because we were the three no votes. Therefore, a reconsideration based on our common council rules cannot be submitted. Corporation Council, can you speak to that for me, please?
I didn't hear your question.
My question is that I want to go back to the reconsideration of motions and resolutions. The three no votes were Alderman Brown, Alderman Dawson, and myself. And we are the majority of that prevailing, and I don't believe this had to be resubmitted and reconsidered by those three votes. And I don't believe we can move anywhere forward with this at this time.
We'll get back to you in a minute.
Discussion with legal counsel. You're correct in that the same meeting or the following regular meeting, which I believe this
evening. I mean, they voted on that agenda, right?
Okay, so we can't vote on it tonight, but at the next regular council meeting, we can, according to my interpretation and legal counsel's interpretation of the rules of order. So, there'll be no vote this evening. Okay.
There's a timeline on it. Okay. Our rules of order, but can we then refer it back to committee?
Again.
That means they will then refer it back to committee, or?
Well, it'll be in committee because that's where it is now. So, if you want to refer it back and.
Well, I still have a few things to say. I just wanted to wait to hear what that was about.
Okay. I appreciate you bringing that up.
I do not sit on the Finance Committee, however, I attend most meetings, and unfortunately, I missed this month's meeting, but I do want to know why Resolution 22 wasn't re-entered with the exact wording of in the sum of $125,000 to purchase multi-space parking meters and related equipment. The new resolution, number 5, says bond ordinance in the sum of $125,000 to fund the purchase of pay stations for off-street parking. And the whereas and section 1 also include the substantially corrective wording that's not, I'm not sure why the wording was changed.
I think what you're saying, the committee before reflects the resolution, all right? It's authorized bonding the amount of $125,000 to fund purchase of PlayStation. Right, so actually, this is a new resolution, so maybe we can be voted on.
A new committee report was passed.
But it doesn't, it says authorized bonding in the amount of $125,000 to fund the purchase of PlayStations for off-street parking. The newer ones requesting bonding authorization in the amount of $125,000 to purchase multi-space parking meters and related equipment implemented in the city lots. And I also have to say that no, it cannot be voted on because this was not submitted by the majority of the no vote. And in order for something to be reconsidered.
It would have to be the same thing to be reconsidered. See, this is actually different.
So why was it changed? Because of that reason, to lower the eyes of people? I mean, why was this resolution not submitted exactly as such? Because that's what was voted down legally and binding by the oath.
Maybe because the mayor sent a letter that asked for this.
Okay, but we have council rules.
But a communication from the mayor is always in order.
Okay, but to, we're resubmitting something because we didn't like the out, that because certain people didn't like the outcome of the vote that was 5-3 and.
Well, you just had to change that.
There's many unfinished information.
This committee report from January is exactly like the one that we passed for this month, February. So they're not different. Exactly the same.
Resolution is written from the committee report.
And the resolution is written from the committee report. So they're exactly the same. And that's why we can't vote it on this meeting this evening, but next month we can.
Okay, and I concur with that, but there's still that the reconsideration of this resolution needed to be submitted by one of the three no votes. So I appreciate that this is not being voted on tonight, and that then allows the public in a few days to start vetting the process and moving forward. I'm not saying I'm against kiosks, I'm not saying I'm against.
Well, you were saying that was being done underhand, and it really wasn't. It's exactly what we.
But it appeared that way to me, so I needed to confirm. So I.
Okay, so it wasn't underhand, it was just, and I, it's my fault, I know about that law, and I just slipped because I thought the next month you could do it, but it has to be the month after that you can do it. Just so.
And the reconsideration of who can submit that to needs to be.
No, I don't think you need that reconsideration according to this rules the way I just read it. And speaking with the Corporation Council, it says it can be without those stipulations. That we can take.
Okay, well, we have a month to discuss that.
Right, we can work that out.
Thank you.
So do you want to refer it back, or do you just want to leave it in committee? We'll be back next month otherwise.
Is there a tangible difference in doing one or the other?
I don't believe so. You can discuss it next month, that's about it. I mean, I'll give you that option.
I mean, for the record, I will also make the motion to refer it back to committee.
That mic doesn't work.
Mic's not on. I'll make the motion to refer it back to committee.
Okay, do I have a second? Okay, I have a question to refer back. There is no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Hereby refer back, 9-0. And we now go to resolution number. Wow, looks like it's moving behind. Well, actually, we were doing 45.
Yeah.
Well, we already met that. So we didn't vote on something that we already passed, so that was kind of crazy. So that doesn't get referred back. What gets referred back is the vote on the bonding, which was defeated. You had 6 votes for it, and you only had 5, because one of you all remember absent, go ahead.
Then number 45
classified should have never even been included in first.
Right.
So.
So as far as I'm concerned, that's already passed. What's referred back, which I'll need another vote on, resolution number 46 of bond, authorizing the bond.
Where's 46?
And that is usually law rule. So I'm going to, you want to make a motion on that, Bill?
Yeah, so I'm making a motion refer. I looked down at what that was, I'm sorry.
That's all that.
Yeah, it's 46, I'm making a motion refer to that.
You just come to that. Okay. So you have a second?
Second.
The bond authorization act. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? 9-0. Refer back. Resolution number 46. Now move to the second reading and vote on proposed local law number 2.
Local law number 2 of 2017 of the Common Council of the City of Kingston, New York, adopting revised rules and regulations of the Board of Electrical Examiners, section 208-14, inspections of the Code of the City of Kingston.
On the question? Hearing no discussion, I'll call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Local law is adopted, 9-0. That concludes the committee reports for this evening. Do I have any recommendations to close the meeting in honor of? No? Okay, I would like to close the meeting in honor of Joe DeCicco. I don't know if nobody was a lifelong resident. President of the water board, he's been water board for many years, actually was serving as chairman and passed away recently. Who's his family? Pete DeCicco, I think it was a large family. I'd like to close the meeting in his honor. And I'm thinking about it. I'd also like to close the meeting in honor of Tom Rice. He lived on Henry Street. He worked in the city for 40 years as a sheet metal worker. He recently passed away. And Gary McGeller is another local resident, 67, I believe. He just recently passed away also. These were all cancer-related illnesses. I think that's pretty much it. Anyone else? No? Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, hearing no one else, can I get a motion to adjourn?
Motion.
Second. All in favor? Hereby stand adjourned to the next regular schedule. Thank you very much.